This is true Arctic wilderness. You can walk around days without seeing anybody. This is absolutely the best place for AMDXing in the entire world.
We are 400 kilometers north of the Arctic Circle.
So now we are a few hundred meters from our cabin.
It's various 3-4 meters above ground.
This is reindeer herding territory and they are a priority here. So that's why we keep the antennas high up. No reindeer get stuck in the wires.
The wires come to one of these two boxes. From these boxes they go into a coax cable, which is like a protected shielded cable. Goes underneath to the ground and then to our cabin.
This one is directed to 290 degrees, East Coast, USA, Caribbean, Colombia, Venezuela. We have 14 such antennas to pick up stations from all around the world. They are more or less 1 kilometer in length.
This is the BBC World Service, the world's radio station.
The BBC relay in Oman.
I don't speak Thai language, but I still recognize the ID. This is Radio Thailand. So this one is from South Korea.
DXing was a window to the world. Before the age of internet and before satellite TV, shortwave radio was the thing. That's how we learned languages, that's how we heard the kind of music that we enjoyed. You never know exactly what you're going to hear. There can be a really narrow opening to some particular direction, and you can hear even dozens of stations that you've never heard before. I just love the challenge of being able to identify what I'm hearing, using all these clues about the frequency and program content language. This is STV in the northern island of Hokkaido in Japan. If we scan the dial upwards, it doesn't have a clear signal. I would guess that this would probably be from Minnesota, KSUM. The radio scene continues to be surprising and challenging and full of possible discoveries. So we try to pick up all the furthest stations, the most weakest signals. There's hardly anybody living here. There's a lot of space for antennas and there's no interference by television sets, electrical appliances. Another advantage in Lapland is that during the winter, the days are really short.
It's 2:30 in the afternoon, November the 20th. You can see the sun has already gone down. So in darkness is really good because AM signal travels far in darkness.
I come to Lapland normally twice a year, and every time that I'm here, I'm trying to go through all the 14 antennas, depending on how much snow there is. It's actually quite tough to walk around here and clean the antennas over snow and ice. It's probably really healthy to get out of the cabin, just enjoy the beauty of this wilderness. The Russian border is exactly 40 kilometers from here. And in between, it's just wilderness. There's no roads, no villages. Even if my dial is full of exotic radio stations, I would come up here and relax and just enjoy the quietness and the stillness of nature here. Sometimes I don't hear much on the radio, and the reason can be high solar activity, which causes the northern lights. So then I just come out here and enjoy the spectacle instead.